Praise the name of the living God. We thank God so much for this morning. Let us pray. Our Lord and our Master Jesus Christ, we bless you this morning. Jehovah God Almighty, our Lord, our God, our King, our Savior, our Maker, our everything. Father, this morning we acknowledge you, O God. We appreciate you for the gift of life. We thank you for blessing us with another day, O God, a day full of your blessings. Father, we believe, we know that, Lord, today you are with us, O God, and today shall be our best day ever, O God. For the path of the just shines brighter and brighter and brighter unto the perfect day. Today, we believe that, Lord, as we have begun our day with you, our light and our path shall shine brighter and brighter today. Father, we invite you to this morning devotion program this morning. Lord, it is your time with your children. It's time that your children come before you, O God, to commune with you. Father, come and lead this program. Jesus Christ, come and take over. Holy Spirit, come and take over. Make this morning devotion truly the true altar of God, where, Lord, everyone that comes here this morning shall encounter you in a mighty way, O God. Father, we thank you. We ask the Lord, let your spirit go and wake up everyone who's supposed to be here. Those who are still sleeping, Lord, send the angels to go wake them up and prompt them and bring them to the altar of your presence. We thank you, we bless you. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. You are all welcome to the platform of God, to the morning devotion. We'll go into our time of worship.
There's nothing worth more that will never come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, oh. I tasted and see of the sweetest of love, where my heart becomes free and my shame is.
Spirit, carry me on wings of eagles, carry me on to the place of prayer, carry me on. Holy Spirit, carry me on to the place of power, carry me. Carry me, oh, to realms of glory, carry me, oh, Holy Spirit, carry me, oh, Holy Spirit, guide me, oh, I need direction, guide me.
Thank you.
We thank God so much for that time of worship. We're going to our time of prayer. And this morning, Sister Winifred will be leading us in our time of prayer. Let's welcome her.
Good morning. Praise the Lord. This morning, you will be praying for yourself. This is a personal prayer to have a heart for God and His kingdom. So you will be praying for yourself. It's a personal prayer to have heart for God and His kingdom. Our first prayer says, Our Father in heaven, thank you for today, the day you have made. I will rejoice and be glad today. I receive the gift of today and I thank you for it. This is the day which the Lord had made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Now let us pray. Father, I thank you. I thank you, my heavenly Father. I thank you because of your goodness and your mercy. Thank you for giving me a new day in the land of the living. It's all because of you. Therefore, I will rejoice and bless your holy name. Thank you, O Lord, for this new day, whereby I am made new for your glory, Lord. Father, thank you for this day. Take total control. Father, thank you. I'm going to be rejoicing, celebrating you, O Lord. And I will praise you for this new day because it's the day that you have made. I thank you, my Lord. I thank you, my Father in heaven. I thank you, Almighty. Come and take all the glory, O Lord. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you, Lord, for this new day. In the name of Jesus, I have prayed. Amen. Father, I thank you in Jesus' name. Now we go to prayer number two, which says, My heavenly Father, give me joy and gladness this year. Let every barrier and resistance on my path of celebration this year be crushed and destroyed by the power of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Joy comes from you. Give me joy, O Lord. Joy like that fountainhead. Peace like the flowing river in this year, Lord. Let your joy and gladness, let it fill my heart. In the name of Jesus, Isaiah 45:1 says, Thus said the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand have I told, holding to subdue nations before him, and I will loose the loins of kings to open before him the two-leaved gates, and the gates shall not be shut. I will go before thee and make the crooked places straight. I will break in pieces the gates of brass and cut in sunder the bars of iron. Lord, I thank you for your blessings. Thank you, O Lord, my God, my heavenly Father. Now restore unto me the joy that no man can give. Give it to me, O Lord, this year, and make the crooked places straight before me in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I just thank you. Thank you because you are there for me to make every crooked place straight. Thank you, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Now we go into prayer number three, which says, Father God Almighty, give me a heart for God. Baptize me with the spirit of dedication, resulting in undeniable order of kingdom commitments in my life. Thank you, Lord. Give me a heart for you, O Lord. Give me the desire to always want to serve in your kingdom. Lord, I pray today, baptize me with that spirit of dedication. Let your kingdom, let it be a top priority in my life. Let me seek your kingdom first, O Lord. Father, help me. John 12:26 says, If any man serve me, let him follow me. And where I am, there shall also my servants be. If any man serve me, him will my Father honor. Hallelujah. To serve you, Lord, is to honor you. Your word declares that those who honor you, you will honor. Father, this morning I'm praying, baptize me with a spirit of dedication so I can continue to serve you in the name of Jesus. Baptize me afresh with a spirit of dedication in the mighty name of Jesus. I have prayed. Amen. And prayer number four says, My Father, I am asking that you specially baptize me with passion for souls, making a fruitful harvester of souls in my walk with you in this land. Lord, I thank you. Baptize me, O Lord. Baptize me, Winifred, with passion for souls. Help me, O Lord. Help me to continue to win souls for you. For you, O Lord, let me win souls for you in the name of Jesus. Proverbs 11:30 says, The fruit of righteousness is a tree of life, and he that winneth soul is wise. Therefore, this morning I am asking, I am calling on to you, O Lord. Give me that desire. Give me that desire to be able to go out there and win souls for you in the mighty name of Jesus, to be able to preach your gospel. Dear Lord, empower me for this great commission so I can bear fruit for you, for your precious seeds, rejoicing and forever grateful in the name of Jesus. Help me, O Lord. Help me, O Lord, so I can be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, which bring forth his fruits in the season. And whatsoever I do, I will prosper in the name of Jesus. Daniel 12:3 says, and they that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that turn many to righteousness as the stars forever in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' name, I have prayed. Amen. Now we're going to prayer number 5. Prayer number 5 says, my Father God Almighty, empower me with the spirit of love so I can continue to love your word, making it become my way of life in the name of Jesus. Father, empower me. Empower me to love your word, O Lord, to meditate on it day and night. Let it be a lamp unto my feet and a light to my path. Help me, O Lord, by your power to keep thy precepts and walk in your ways in the name of Jesus. Psalm 119:97 says, oh, how I love thy law. It is my meditation all the day. Though through thy commandments has made me wiser than my enemies, for they are ever with me. I have more understanding than all my teachers, for thy testimonies are my meditation. I understand more than the ancients because I precepts. Help me, O Lord, to keep thy precepts. Help me to love your word, O Lord, and to continue to walk in it. In the name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. Now let's go to prayer number 6. Prayer number 6 says, Heavenly Father, by the power of the Holy Ghost, grant me supernatural utterance that will prick the hearts of every unsaved soul unto repentance as I minister unto them. Heavenly Father, I pray for that boldness. Give me that boldness to speak your word freely, sharing my faith in Christ so many can come to receive you as their Lord and Savior. Acts 2:37 says, now when they heard this, they were pricked in their hearts and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remissions of sins, and ye shall receive the gifts of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Father, your word says the righteous are as bold as lion. I pray this morning, give me that boldness. Give me that boldness to be able to share your gospel, my faith in Christ. Help me, O Lord. Let me step out there and bring people my way. In the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. Now we're going to the last prayer, prayer number 7. Prayer number 7 says, my glorious Father, anoint me afresh with the oil of gladness so I can make the most of my kingdom advancement endeavors with unending rewards. It comes with its rewards. So Father, I thank you this morning. Thank you for your reward, which is unending. I'm asking for your fresh anointing, fresh oil of gladness, so I can be of great service to promote your kingdom, to promote your kingdom here on earth. Dear Lord, help me. Habakkuk 3:17 says, although the fig tree shall not blossom, neither shall fruits be in the vines, the labors of the olive shall fail, and the fields shall yield no meat. The flock shall be cut off from the fold, and there shall be no herd in the stalls. Yet I will rejoice in the Lord. Father, help me to continue to celebrate you, to rejoice in you. Father, empower me to be able to accomplish your will in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, give me a serving heart, a serving spirit, to serve you with all my heart and to serve you joyfully in the name of Jesus. We have prayed this morning. Amen. Thank you, Father, for answering our prayers. Thank you for your unconditional love. Thank you, O Lord, for your agape love. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.
Amen. Amen. We thank God so much for this time of prayer. We believe God has answered our prayers. The Bible says that his ears are inclined unto the prayer of the righteous. And it said, before you ask, I have heard it. Even whilst you yet speak, I have answered you. So we believe and we know that God has answered our prayers this morning. And we give all the glory, all the honor and praise unto him in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Now we'll go into our Bible reading. And this morning we will be reading from Exodus chapter 9, verse 1 to 7. Exodus chapter 9, from verse 1 to 7. And Sister Lydia will be reading for us. Let's welcome Sister Lydia.
Good morning, family. We're reading Exodus chapter 9, verse 1 to 7. Then the Lord said to Moses, go to Pharaoh and say to him, this is what the Lord, the God of the Hebrews, says, let my people go so that they may worship me. If you refuse to let them go and continue to hold them back, the hand of the Lord will bring a terrible plague on your livestock in the field, on your horses, donkeys, camels, and on your cattle, sheep, and goats. But the Lord will make a distinction between the livestock of Israel and that of Egypt, so that no animal belonging to the Israelites will die. The Lord set a time and said, tomorrow the Lord will do this in the land. And the next day the Lord did it. All the livestock of the Egyptians died, but not one animal belonging to the Israelites died. Pharaoh investigated and found that not even one of the animals of the Israelites had died, yet his heart was unyielding and he would not let the people go. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise be the name of the living God. We thank God so much. This morning we have Pastor Ernest to bring the word of God to us. Let's welcome Pastor Ernest. Amen.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We thank God for yet another time in his presence. Hallelujah. Peter said times of refreshing are in the presence of the living God. Hallelujah. So we've come this morning in his presence to be refreshed, spirit, soul, and body. Glory be to God. We're still talking on kingdom service. That's our theme. That's our topic for the entire week. Yesterday, we started looking at what is kingdom service. Glory be to God. And among other things, we said kingdom service is the use of our God-given resources, like time, like strength, talent, and finances in promoting the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. We use it in promoting the kingdom of God. And we said, kingdom service is an active participation in the work of God for its progress. For its progress. It is also consciously surrendering one's self for the Lord's use in his kingdom. Surrendering oneself for God to use in his kingdom. And we said it's not limited to the fivefold ministry. That commission is given to every child of God. It's a commandment and it's a covenant walk with God. God demands service of us. As we've seen in the scripture that we just read, if we look in the book of Exodus, there are numerous occasions that God demanded from Pharaoh that he let the children, let his people go for only one reason, that they may serve him. Glory be to God. They may serve. That's the only reason why he came to deliver them, that they may offer him service. They may be of service to him. So kingdom service is a requirement for each and every one. As long as we call ourselves a believer, as long as we call ourselves born again Christian, God demands service of us in his kingdom with our time, with our strength, with our talent, with our finances, with our entire being. That's a demand placed on us by God. Now, this morning, we're going to look at the purpose of kingdom service. The purpose of kingdom service. Why kingdom service? Now, the very first thing is we are saved to serve God. We are saved to serve God. Now, 1 Peter 2:9, I'll read from the Message translation. I like that translation very much. It says, but you are the ones chosen by God. Glory be to God. God himself has chosen us, chosen for the high calling of priestly work, chosen to be a holy people. Is it God's instruments to do his work and speak out for him. We're here on earth to tell others of the night and day difference he made for you, from nothing to something, from rejected to accepted. Glory be to God. We are God's instruments to do his work and speak out for him. That is why God chose you and I. There were numerous people in this world, but God has chosen you and I for this specific work, to serve him. So he has chosen us for a particular mission. Jesus also saying in the book of John 15, verse 16, he said, you did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit, that your fruit should remain. Hallelujah. So we see the word choose. So God saved us to serve him. He chose us for a particular mission. First, he chose us. Then he didn't just send us out. He equipped us. He said, I have appointed you. I have equipped you and set us on the go. Not only on the go, but to what? For our work also to be fruitful, for our work also to be fruitful. Glory be to God, to be fruitful. In the book of Micah 6:8, it talks about the duty of man. He said, what God is looking for in men and women is quite simple. They do what is fair and just to your neighbor, be compassionate and loyal in love, and don't take yourself too seriously. That means what? Life does not center around you. Take God seriously. God is the center of everything. He is the epicenter of everything. Take God seriously, his word seriously. So God has saved us to serve him. He has saved us to serve him. Now another purpose is we are ambassadors for Christ Jesus, and we are to continue with the work he started on earth. All of us on this platform are ambassadors for Christ Jesus. As long as we've accepted him as our Lord, our Master, our Savior, we are his ambassador. And we know that an ambassador does the bidding or sees to the interest of the country or the kingdom he or she is representing. He does the bidding. He sees to the interest of God. As what? We are ambassadors of Jesus Christ, and we are to continue with the work that he started here on earth. That is why before he was lifted up, he told him to go forth. Go forth. That's the commission. Go forth. Go forth into the world. He's sending us to be ambassadors of him. Luke 19:13 says, so he called this parable of the talent. He called his 10 servants and trusted him. He was talking about the Lord traveling for a long time. Entrusted to them 10 pounds and said to them, trade until I come. Hallelujah. Trade until I come. So all of us have been entrusted with one thing or the other, one talent or the other. We are to do what? To trade with it by being an ambassador. To trade means what? To work. To work with it, to reap the benefit of it for the kingdom of God. Some other translation says, operate with this until I return. So the talent he has given you, we are supposed to do a trade, and by trading, we are representing him. That is why we are ambassadors of him. We are working ambassadors of the Lord Jesus Christ, soldiers on assignment. John 14, 12 says, truly, truly, I say to you, he who believes in me will do the works that I do also, and he will do greater works than these because I am going to my Father. We read the scripture and normally we think, okay, so I'm going to do greater works than the Lord Jesus Christ. I mean, I understand why we say that. But that's not what the scripture is referring to. Jesus was talking and he said, anyone who believes in me will do the works that I do and what greater works. Now we understand that Jesus was limited when he was in his earthly ministry over here because he was in a physical body. He can't be at two places at the same time. Now what this scripture is referring is you and I as ambassadors of Christ. If we are able to draw many, if you're able to bring many into the kingdom, if we have an ambassador of Christ in every nation, every county, in every city, in every neighborhood, each of us in the body of Christ, in service to God, will do a greater works. Because Jesus couldn't be at two places at the same time, but the church as a body of Christ, in service to God, will do greater works than what he did, because it will be happening worldwide. It will be happening worldwide because we'll have a far more outreach than Jesus did. So this morning, my question is, imagine having an active and impactful ambassador of Christ in every block, in every neighborhood. What would the end result be? An ambassador of Christ who is what? Having an impact, who is active. What will the end result be? That is the greater works that Jesus is talking about. So we are sent forth. We are ambassadors for Jesus Christ. And we are to continue with the work he started here on earth. Another purpose for service is for the prosperity of God's work and the propagation of the gospel. The prosperity of God's work and the propagation, the spread of the gospel. Serving God with our resources and our being ensures the word can reach every corner of the world. Remember, Jesus is not coming until the word reaches every corner, until everyone has had the opportunity to hear it, until every city, every neighborhood has had that opportunity to hear it. And how is that going to spread? Through us, through our service, through our sisters, through helping fund the evangelist, the apostle, the pastor, the teacher, to go. If we can't go physically, what? Our resources should be able to fund those that can go. And the rewards is still the same. Glory be to God. Now, if we check the history of the Bible and how the Bible spread, we'll realize how men put their lives on the line. Even the translation of the Bible from Greek, Hebrew, whatever it is, to English, it took a lot of effort from men for it to be made available for us today to read and study it in the comfort of our homes. So we are to use our resources. We are to serve God with our resources to make sure God's work prospers in our community, in our cities, in our nations, and the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ spreads. You read the book of Acts, you can see the zeal with which Paul had to bring the word of God to every city that he came across. To the point that it took sometimes the Holy Spirit to prevent him, to stop him from going to certain cities, because that's not the plan of God for now. But that zeal he had to spread the word. The reason why he was incarcerated in Rome was because he wanted to take that gospel to his people, regardless of all the word of knowledge that came forth concerning that trip. So we have been saved to carry that same zeal, that same passion to ensure God's word continues to propagate and prosper in our cities, in our communities. Another reason, another purpose why we have to serve is to tap into God's blessing. Now, 2 Timothy 2:6 says, the farmer who labors should be first to partake of the crops. Hallelujah. And we read from Deuteronomy yesterday, you shall serve the Lord your God, and he is the one who will bless thy bread and thy water, and he will take sickness away from the midst of thee. And that's the welfare and the well-being package of the kingdom of God. We'll expand more on the benefits of service later during this week. But another purpose of it is to tap into God's blessing. Glory be to you. So let's remember what kingdom service is about. Is the meeting of the needs of filling of gaps. It's the offering of one of help and kindness, assistance. Kingdom service is the making of the difference or the addition of value. It's the offering of satisfaction. It's the running of errands. God's work is the availability for instructions, making yourself available for instructions or readiness for others. Kingdom service is the deployment of effort, time, and ability to offer solutions. Remember, purpose of kingdom service, among many of it, is we are saved to serve God. He said, we are God's instrument to do his work and speak out for him. The angels are not going to do that. That's why we are here on earth, to do that. God doesn't send the angels to go minister to someone to become a Christian. No, that's our job. So we are saved to serve God. We are ambassadors for Jesus Christ, and we are to continue his work, his ministry that he started here on earth. And we are called to serve for the prosperity of God's work and propagation of the gospel and to tap into God's blessing. So this morning, as we go into our personal moment, our personal time with the Lord, among other things that we are going to present, among other petitions that we are going to present to him, one of which should be, Lord, give me a heart to serve. Give me a heart to serve. God himself said, I will take away the stony heart and give you a heart of the flesh. It's a new spirit what I put in you. And not just that, he will cause us to walk in his statutes and keep his judgments. He will put a heart of the flesh and a new spirit and cause us to walk in his statutes and keep his judgments. And one of his statutes is kingdom service, serving him with your God-given resources. So Lord, this morning, give me a heart to serve, a heart to serve, a heart to serve. Take away that stony heart that does not regard kingdom service and put in me a zeal and a passion. Like the Lord Jesus said, I am of my Father's business. I am of my Father's business. So give me that heart for everything concerning the kingdom of God to be a passion, to be a strong desire of mine. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let's go into our personal moment and we'll be back shortly.
Hallelujah. We give God praise. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. I want to believe you are open to God, hearing his words, and allowing those words to have impact upon your life. Service in the kingdom is non-negotiable. In fact, it goes before in the heart of God, in most cases in determining what God will do. Let my people go that they may serve me. That's the only call for it. You can't go all about your life Monday through Sunday, if I put it that way, do your own, run after your own, mind your own, and then you come back, be asking him for things. He said, and you shall serve the Lord, and the Lord shall bless. You shall serve him, and then he shall bless. Bless your bread, bless your water, take sickness away from your midst. The number of your face you will fulfill. No aborted vision, all the blessings attached to service. We serve God in diverse ways, principally with our resources for his kingdom, your strength, your intellect, your gifts. We always put that first, and then the blessings of God continually follows. And the king cried out and said, O servant of the Most High God, that was concerning Daniel, your God whom thou servest is able to deliver you. And Daniel answered from the pit of death, if I put it that way, from the belly of death, in the midst of the lions. Having spent time with the lions, where people thought he was dead, but then he cried out, oh my Lord the King, the God that I serve has sent his angels and has shut the mouth of the lions, and that there was no iniquity found in me. He delivers his own that serves him. You won't need to call, he's always there. Glory to God. Well, let's have Pastor Jesus bless us before we go this morning.
Amen. Amen. We thank God so much for that beautiful word of God that has come to us this morning. We thank God so much for the reminder that God expects us to serve him. He's the master and we are his servants. And the word servant or service is a doing word. It comes with work. You are working for the master. You know, worshiping God, waking up and praying, and they are all good, but it's not the same as service. Service means doing something for God. So I hope you and I will make our mind, we'll set ourselves to do something for God. Now let's receive the blessing of the day. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you, O God. Your word says, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all these other things shall be added unto you. Father, this morning, your children have come to spend the early hour of their morning with you. They have come to seek you, O God. Father, today, O God, let all be added unto them, O God. Let all the good things of life be added unto your children today. Father, I declare today a day of recovery for your children, O God. A day of rest, a day of refreshing, a day of recovery, a day of restoration. You said, I will restore unto you the years that the locust, the power of the caterpillar, the caterpillar, I, the Lord, I will restore unto you. Father, I declare today a day of restoration for all your children on this platform in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, we believe your hand will do it in Jesus' name. Amen. As we all know, this program runs Monday through Friday, 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. Mountain Time. And we're encouraging all of us to invite friends and bring them here in Jesus' name. Let us share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen. Have a blessed day. God be with you today. Amen.